Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, summer is just flying by. Can you believe it's the second week of July already? Hey, today's question is from Carrie in New York. Carrie is trying to set up links between one worksheet and another worksheet. Now, Carrie has data that she fills in back here on the detail sheets, and then right now she's taking that data and rekeying it on the summary sheet, and there's a better way to go. Now, this initially seems very confusing, how to set up links, because when you look at the formulas seem to have different syntax depending on what's going on. So here we have an equal sign, the worksheet name is no space, a bang, in other words, the exclamation point, programmers call that a bang, and then the address where we want to go, C5. But if your worksheet name happened to have a space, then it gets much more confusing because you have the equal sign, an apostrophe, the worksheet name, another apostrophe, the bang, and the cell character. If you're going to an external workbook, so in other words, we want to link to a worksheet and another workbook, oh, well, then it gets even worse. Left square bracket, workbook name, right square bracket, the worksheet name, a bang, and the cell address. Unless there's a space in there, then we wrap that whole thing, equal sign, apostrophe, and so on. Out here, finally, the apostrophe, the bang, and the cell address. Now, here's the good news. You do not have to learn any of those rules at all. All you have to be able to do is type an equal sign. So we type an equal sign. If I want to go and grab a value from the no space worksheet, click on no space, choose the cell that I want, and press enter, and we're done. If the worksheet happens to have a space, it's the exact same thing. Type the equal sign, click on the other worksheet, click on the cell that you want, and press enter. And Excel worries about building the proper syntax. Now, if it's an external workbook, definitely easier if you have that workbook open. So we type an equal sign here, and then we can come down to the taskbar and go to the Link to Me worksheet, choose the cell that we want, OK, or equal sign and one of the workbooks with spaces, and choose the cell that we want, click OK. Now, one thing you want to notice is that when I'm going to another sheet in this book, they don't put the dollar signs in. So F8, if I would copy this formula, would be free to copy. If I would go right, it would change to G8, H8, and so on. However, if we're going to an external workbook, by default, they put dollar signs in that cell reference. You might want to press F4 one, two, three times to clear that out, especially if you're going to be copying the formula across or down. So there you have it, an easy way to build cell links. You don't have to worry about the horrible syntax, you know, whether you put the apostrophe for the left square bracket or right, don't need to know that. Type the equal sign, go click on the cell that you want, and Excel will build your links. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.